Hi folks, greetings for the day. So today we are going to discuss about variables. Now let's see what are variables. Here the variables are typically used to store information which your Java program needs to do its job, and a Java variables is a piece of memory that can contain a data value, and a variable thus has a data type as well. Now let's take a simple example that age is storing some value called 20. Here you can see age is a variable name that I am considering to specify my memory location. Here 20 is storing somewhere, and that memory location is specified with name age. Now let's see the types of variables. We have two types of variables. One is global variable, which is also called as member variable, and another is local variables. Here the global variables are some variables which can be accessed throughout the program. And here we have local variables. Here the local variables are variables declared inside a method, and a local variables is only accessible inside the method that declared it. Means here the local variables can be accessed only within a scope. In global variables, we have two types of global variables. One is static and another is non-static. Here the static field is a variable that belongs to a class, and a static field has the same value for all the objects that access it. And non-static field is a variable that belongs to an object. Objects keeps their internal state in non-static fields only. Here you may not understand what are objects and classes, but you will be understanding it in further videos. Now let's see the naming convention of Java variables. Here the Java variables can consist of capital letters, lower letters, and digits and special characters as well. But while starting the variable name, you should start with letter or underscore or dollar only. You cannot start your variable name with digit or by using any other special characters rather than dollar and underscore. Here, blank spaces cannot be used in variable names. Means if you are declaring your variable name by using two words, you cannot use spaces in between that two words, but you can merge that both the words and you can specify it as single name. And Java variables names are case sensitive, because here the name like lower letters of money cannot be equal to uppercase letters money. Hence it is a case sensitive. And here the variable names cannot be equal to reserve words in Java. Means what are reserve words? In Java, int, float, double, and for, do, while, and some other words are reserve words that you cannot declare as a variable name. So these are the naming convention that you need to follow while declaring the variables. Now let's see how we are going to declare a variable. We have a syntax, data type followed by a variable name. This is a syntax for variable declaration. Here the data type is used to specify the type of data that you are storing into this variable name. Let's take an example that int age. Here int is a data type and age is a variable name. Means if we are declaring data type as int, it can only store non-decimal values. See here. Age is a name given to a memory location, but I'm not storing anything here because I'm just declaring but not assigning any value to the age. I'm just giving name to my memory location. I'm just declaring it. And let's see one more example. Double height. Double is a data type which can store decimal numeric values, because height will be like 5.0, 5.1. So such kind of data can be stored into height. Here I'm just declaring it but not initializing. Hence I'm just specifying the name to my memory location but not storing any value in this memory location. So this is all about variable declaration. Now let's see the variable initialization. And we have syntax. Here variable name equals to value. variable name is to specify specify the memory location, and value is something which can be stored into this variable name. Let's see example. Here age is a variable name and 20 is a value, where 20 should be stored in a memory location called age. You can see here I am storing this 20 in a memory location age. Here age is a name given to a memory location, and in that memory location I am storing this 20 as a value. Here you can see the difference. Here I am initializing a value to age, but here I am just declaring it. While declaring, I am not storing any value, but initializing it, I am storing some value in it. And here is a one more example, height. Here height is a name specified to a memory location, and I am storing 5.6 in its memory. So this is all about variable initialization. Now let's see variable declaration and initialization together. We can do variable declaration and initialization together also. So here's our syntax, where data type followed by variable name equals to value. Here, let's take an example. Int is as my data type, and marks as a variable name, and 90 as a value. As I said, here the data type is something which specify what kind of data that can be stored into a variable name. Here I can't store a 90.0 in marks, because I have declared my data type as int. So you have to store only non-decimal numeric values in this memory location called marks. And we have one more example. Let's take char as my data type and gender as my variable name, and I'm storing m in it. Here I can't store some string values or something, because here character is a data type which can only store char type of data. Here int is a data type which can store only integer type of data. So here this is how we are going to declare and initialize the variables. So this is all about variables and variables naming conventions and variable declaration and initialization. Thank you.